to an honoured unhurt Frank Sinatra, especially after you were born on his birthday.
She thought it was a sign you'd be good at music. She'd love to tell me the story about how Frank's music helped you through a difficult time. Oh, yes, it was during the war she married your granddad. She looked lovely, dressed as American.
Yeah, one yank and it was off.
Gran often said that music helped her deal with the ugly things in life.
Might do, but it don't pay any bills.
I loved her story about meeting your granddad at a Sinatra concert before the war. Baba didn't approve of Sinatra, thought his songs were scandalous. She had to go to a friend's house to get changed before the concert so she could go. It was Gran who gave me my love of music, teaching me to play her own piano. I'd love to pass that on to other people.
How are you going to do that then?
By writing songs and performing, like Frank Sinatra did when he started out.
Music's all right as a hobby, but you still need a proper job in life.
Mum, Dad, I need to talk to you both.
I knew it! She's one of those lesbians!
Shut up! I've made an important decision about the direction I want to take. I want to go to college for music and the performing arts.
Bullshit!
Check!
We talked about this. I thought you wanted to do another year at school and then take over the family store.
No, you wanted me to do that. I said I'd think about it.
Seems like you've not been thinking at all.
There's not enough working in the store on weekends and in the holidays, but I just can't see myself working there forever.
It were good enough for your grandparents and good enough for me and all.
But my passion is music. This is 1985 and I just want to follow my dream.
Bloody dreams, that's all I hear.
Now, Jack, there's no need to swear.
I'll bloody swear if I want. This is my ass and I don't want to see my daughter throwing her life away trying to scrape a living playing in some seedy bar.
Frank Sinatra's parents wanted him to be an engineer. Look how that turned out.
Frank bloody Sinatra, that's all I hear about these days.
You see an expensive course that you're looking at. It's not too bad. I've saved up some money from working in the shop and I should get a grant. Plus, there's that money that Gran left me.
That's to put you through college. Proper college. Not some poncy singing and dancing place.
I'm sure Gran would have been happy for me to use her money to go to music college.
What you should be doing is doing another year at school, then going to business college.
But I don't want to do that. I want to study music.
Don't shout, Melody. That doesn't help.
Look, you're 18 in a few months. So I suppose I can't stop you from doing that course. But it's the wrong choice, simple as that. Don't expect any support.
Choice.
Oh, well, you're like playing in a seedy bar. I was thinking of fakes and Campari.
Then how are you at me? Mum, this is England 1985, not 1950 Chicago.
It's not worry about you.
Look, you're making a big mistake. And you're a bit.
Eventually. It always work in the shop if it doesn't turn out well.
But it will, Mum. I'm sure it will.
So when does the call start?
In the middle of September, so there's plenty of time.
Plenty of time? What do you mean there's plenty of time? Are you out of your mind? Got to book the course, find your accommodation, start getting your stuff packed, sort some food out, get some...
It'll be fine. I'll get it all done in time.
And get a bit started on sorting some things out for you then.
Okay, Gran.
Thank you.
London prices. Shame it's such a waste of money.
I'll be all right. I've got my warm duvet.
At least the bathroom's nice and clean.
Not after your mum's been there.
Yeah,
shit.
Stop fussing, Mum. It'll be fine. I'll be spending most of my time at college anyway.
Sure you got everything you need?
Yep, I've got my clothes, food, drink, money, my keyboard, my guitar, my Walkman, and my Commodore 64. What else do I need?
Well, that's the last of the box out the car. We'd better go. The meter's run out, and I don't want a ticket.
Bye, Dad.
Don't bother about him, he'll be okay.
At least he came, I didn't think he would.
Well, he wasn't going to, but I told him I wasn't driving all the way to London on my own. And we needed him to help with your boxes.
I still wish he was happy with what I'm doing.
Let's be patient with him.
Don't let this ruin your relationship.
I never got much time to spend with my dad to appreciate what you've got. He only wants what's best for you.
I know, but it's his idea of what's best, not mine.
Don't worry about him. Got your own future to look forward to. I'm coming, my grown-up girl!
Achieve for me, I can do this, make tutor this year. I will be teaching you songwriting, musical theatre, and performance technique. So, could you all tell me a little bit about yourself, what you play, and who your influences are? Right, first, Marcus Grant.
That's me. I play bass and guitar, like Bob Dylan and Bob Marley. Anyone else who's got a good rhythm going, you know?
Great, thanks, Marcus. Next, Sally Hart.
Oh, that's me. Hi, I'm here to have some fun singing and playing the clarinet until I can find myself a wealthy husband and have lots of kids.
Are you serious? This is 1985, not 1955. You've gotta get into the groove.
I might change my mind if I make it big. I take it you're a Madonna fan then.
Yeah, she was great at Live Aid.
Did you go? Or did you watch on telly?
I went. It was great. I think he'll go down as one of the greatest concerts ever.
I would have loved to have gone, but 25 quid a ticket was too much for me. I watched on telly instead.
I would have watched it, but my dad was like paying radio rentals, so they took the TV away. I'm not sure if I'm here or not.
Thank God! There's always one!
I'm Andy Mills. I want to make money doing something I love. Oh, and I like Johnny Cash.
Johnny Cash? That's the change you get for a Durex machine.
Okay! Next, Jerry Ramsey!
I'm Jerry. I love to sing and play guitar. I want to learn to write better songs. I like the performance side of things, but I'm not really bothered about the whole fame and fortune thing.
And who are your influences?
Oh, I love David Bowie. I'd love to be able to write songs like he does.
Thanks, Jerry. Next, Melody Taylor. We've already heard you sing, but could you tell us a little bit about yourself, please?
I play keyboard and guitar. I also sing and write my own songs. I love Frank Sinatra. I just want to be a musician.
I'm surprised someone of your age likes Frank Sinatra.
I heard a lot of his records when I was younger. Do you like him, Mrs. Page?
He's good, my dear, but I much prefer Never Mind the Bollocks by the Sex Pistols. Anyway, in a piece in your The Baby of the Class, it says here that you're only 17, is that right?
Yes, I'm not 18 until the 12th of December. I have the same birthday as Frank Sinatra.
Frank Sinatra, awesome. And, yes, and you did do your second year of A-levels?
I passed music after 1 year, but the rest were really boring. Anyway, Frank Sinatra dropped out of high school to sing in nightclubs.
Thanks, Melody. And finally, Amber Todd.
Yes, miss.
Oh, no need for miss. I'm for Mrs. Page.
Okay, Mrs. Page. I'm a dancer, singer, and I play the drums.
Can I play your bongos?
Simple, but no one understands. You can't take the demand.
they're important in my songs. I'll tell you what, you don't want to go for a drink sometime, do you? We can compare notes. I've often wondered what girls dream about.
You'd be shocked if you knew about my dreams, then.
Is that why he and Lewis meant that the power of love was stronger and harder than a bad girl's dream?
I must have been the bad girl he was talking about. What do you reckon, Jerry? Are your dreams bad?
Ignore them, Jerry. Going for a drink sounds like a great idea.
Jerry's a quick worker, isn't he?
We're just going for a drink, that's all.
That's what they all say.
been 2 weeks since we first met.
At least this is a more successful date than going to the pub that first time.
Oh, my.
Thank you. doing?
It says concentrate.
What happened to your ear?
I had an accident.
Can see that will happen.
Well, I was ironing some trousers. And the phone rang.
What about your other ear?
Just call back.
You know, Andy, when I sit really close to your ear, up near the ocean.
What's that supposed to mean? I'm smart.
Yeah, right.
I am. I did put up with this jigsaw puzzle in 6 hours, and the box said 5 to 8 years.
Melody and Jerry got together. I thought I was that fast moving where the boys are concerned. Talking of boys, what do you think of Marcus?
He's a great guy. Really laid back. Getting a bit lonely, are you?
Not really. It's great to have made so many new friends already. Still fancy Marcus. Keep smiling at him and waving at him and hoping that'll ask me out. It's a Halloween disco next week. I really want to go with him.
Why don't you just ask him?
Well, I have to if he doesn't make a move soon. Usually, blokes are like moths. They don't have a chance, so I like my flame.
Do you want me to ask him for you?
If you're quite finished, I'd like to hear some music, please. I hope you both remember what I said about working hard, and that doesn't include gossiping. You both need to do much more, much, much more. Leaves have fallen to the ground and summer's gone. Been around, you and I are through now, it's over. Oh yes, lovely, lovely. Just keep concentrating on the music.
I can't believe it's the end of November already. This time's flying past.
Yeah.
I know. Playing for songwriting.
Look, you just gotta relax and let it flow.
We could do with Amber on drums to help with the beat.
Yeah. Drummers are a bit mad, aren't they? Do you know the difference between a drummer and a savings bond? A savings bond eventually matures and makes some money.
More if I want to talk.
Speaking of money, has anyone heard of any part-time jobs? I need to get some money sooner. I ain't gonna eat.
Ran out of ready?
Didn't have much to begin with. I've got a grant for accommodation, but apart from that, I've got nothing to live on.
You're talking about scrapping grants and bringing in student loans?
That will be bad.
Anyway, we better make some music.
Yeah.
How are things going with Jerry?
It's real. I think it could be the real thing. It's the real thing, Hopkins. You must be careful, honey. This is love you're talking about. But don't come easy, so don't get in too deep. You're only 17.
I love that truth at 17. That love is there for beauty queen.
Sounds like you're really hooked. Sal, how is your plan going to get your claws into Marcus?
to see your new proper kids on the block.
Oops! This is Max Blake. He's a talent scout and benefactor of the college. He appears around this time every year to see if there's anybody he fancies for his agency.
Yeah, don't mind me, kids. Just carry on with what you were doing.
Right! What's the new song called?
Oh, it's called Time. Yeah.
as you know.
Yeah, but they should have a hugging.
Melody and Joey, I have high hopes for those two. There's a lot of talent this year. A lot of these students will go really far if they just stick to it.
Well, I like the look of young Melody. It's a shame she's so hopped onto that boy, although he's got some talent as well.
Yes, they've been going out for a few months, but it hasn't affected their work. In fact, I think it's improved their songwriting. They've added more emotion.
Yeah. I don't care about that. They're way too young to be getting serious. They'll probably break up soon anyway. What Melody needs is a real man to show them a thing or two about emotions.
Don't even think about it. She's only a girl.
She's old enough to move away to college, so it's fine by me. As Lizzie said, I'm a talent scout. I'm 8 years. I've signed some of the promising youngsters on this course. I'm thinking you might be the first one I'll consider signing up.
Well, that's amazing. But you've only heard one song, are you sure?
I've been watching a few of your performances while no one's been watching me. Always got my gut feeling. Opportunity could be knocking on your door, my dear. Yeah. Come to my office, 12, on Saturday. It's not far from here.
So, did Max sound interested?
I think so. He wants me to meet him at his office on Saturday.
That's great. It's a shame I'm busy on Saturday. I feel like I ought to come with you.
Oh, don't worry about it, Mrs. Page. I'll be fine.
Just do me a favour. Let me know if you get an audition and I'll try to come along with you. I might even bring a friend of mine. Just keep an eye on Max, won't you?
Why?
I don't trust him. He likes to exploit people.
Don't worry, Mrs. Page. I'll be fine. He'll be fine.
Let me tell someone you signed up. your mobile phone. It's great. I can make a call from anywhere. It's so compact. Hello? Sammy? Yeah, it's me, Max. What? Yeah, she signed up. Yes, at the studio. That's fine by me. Okay, see you then. Ciao. Well, my dear, that's set for Tuesday at 2 o'clock.
That's great. Everything's going so fast. What song should I sing for him?
Tell you what, you've only got one slot, but it's 3 minutes. So, you better do something that I've chosen for you. It's a song called Nasty Talk. A song that I've written, obviously. Make sure you learn it by Saturday.
Well, can't I do one of my own songs?
You get plenty of time to do that once you get the deal.
Say so, Max.
You're a quick learner, my dear. Also, one other thing. I was thinking of giving Jerry an audition as well.
That would be amazing.
Although, there is something stopping me signing them up. You might be able to help.
Anything.
You kids can't be in a relationship anymore.
What? But we love each other.
That's besides the fact, my dear. To get anywhere in this business, you need to be young, sexy, single.
But we can't break up.
You need to be a sexy young star, my dear, to get anywhere in this industry. Just think of all them articles and Jackie and smashing records about them young performers. They're all sexy and available.
I don't read Jackie or Smash Hits. I'm serious about music.
So am I, my dear. But it's the girls who read Smash Hit Records and Jackie that go and buy all your singles.
I'm sure it's the only way.
I won't be able to sign Jerry up unless you two split up.
You can't break up.
Well, that's besides the fact. You need to break off with him so we can have his chance as well. The other thing is, my dear, when you sign him up, you can't tell him the real reason. You might do something stupid when love is concerned. You told him the real reason. You do something silly like sacrifice his chance of starting to be with you. You wouldn't want to end his career from starting out, would you?
No.
Well, tell him you don't love him anymore.
No, I'm lying.
You're training to be an actress to convince him.
You're sure it's the only way?
So I can sign him up as well.
Okay then, I'll do it.
Now you're talking, my dear. You're playing to win.
You can lose as long as you to look after my investment. So scram, dump the kid, and I'll see you Saturday.
Shall I bring Jerry with me?
No. Just for you now. I'll sort Jerry out later. Make sure you do not tell him the real reason.
Okay, see you Saturday.
Saunders.
It's not that good, I didn't see you last night.
Mel, do I plonk and film for both loves, eh?
Don't suppose you want to come down to the pub, have a few drinks and forget about women?
No, I don't fancy it. Think I'll just stay around and have a yawn.
Sometimes, sometimes, sometimes.
studio you've got here, Sam.
Yeah, okay, thanks, Max. Whatever. Do you want a drink?
Yeah. I could do with a cappuccino.
Excuse me, what does your assistant do all day?
Nothing.
Good. She can get the drinks in.
Bitch.
Get me a cappuccino for that kiss ass and get me a tall, skinny caramel macchiato latte with an extra shot.
What?
Cappuccino! Bloody YTS.
Well, you look like your new Beamer.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, not 60 now.
Oh, I might get one of those when I get rid of the old Quattro.
This isn't tall enough, and you're not skinny enough. So, you still finding plenty of fresh, young talent?
Yeah. Still using my version of slash and burn. You ready? Exploit and dump. Works while I make some loads of money.
You seem to hate all the young musicians that you sign up. Why is that? Are you jealous of their youth and talent?
I suppose I might be. I tried music college myself, but didn't get on with it. Too much emphasis on boring practice.
So you thought being a music agent was an easier life?
Yes, and it is. Let them do all the hard work.
Tell me some more about young Mel, then.
Oh, Mel. She's a doll. A bit rough musically, but I'm sure there's something there. She changes her attitude.
What's wrong with her attitude?
She's too sugary sweet. She needs to toughen up a bit.
Sam, there's
a paper next to you. Can I have Bananarama? I'm not interested. So, you're always after your show.
Yes, I am after my own show. Thank you very much. And why not?
I suppose you've got to learn to sing one of your songs.
Of course.
Well, that definitely ain't Bananarama.
Hello, Lizzie. Ooh, who's this delightful creature you brought with you?
This is my friend Erica. Mel did check it was okay for us to come along to her audition.
Yeah. As long as you stay quiet.
Thanks. I like to keep an eye on my students.
I don't think you know Sam Hughes, do you? Sammy, this is, Lizzie. Oh, and this is Erica.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
No, I don't think so.
When's Melly getting here? We need to get started. I've got lunch with boy George in an hour.
Sorry, I'm late.
The bus didn't turn up.
Melody. This is Sammy Hughes, one of the top record company executives in the whole business.
Hello. Heard a lot about you.
Good to meet you.
Hey, Mel. This is my friend Erica. We can have a chat after the audition.
Hi, Erica. Nice to meet you.
Okay, then. Cut the crap. Let's get started. Not got long to spare.
Max, I'm really worried about the song you've chosen for me to record. It's just not right for my voice. Can I swap, please?
Don't be silly. You just haven't practiced enough.
I've practiced it for ages. I'd be much more comfortable singing one of my own songs.
No, I want you to do this one. You'll get nowhere in this business if you do your own songs, especially if you're an unknown performer. Plus, in the contract, it says I get to choose your songs, and I've chosen Nasty Talk.
Okay. I don't know why, but I feel really nervous.
Oh dear. As Frankie says, relax, don't do it.
Okay then, Melody. I've got the music that Max let me have. Let's hear what you've got. You've got 3 minutes.
Sorry about that. I got a bit lost. Can I start again?
No, you can't start again. That was awful.
Sammy, just give her a break. She's just nervous. Why don't you give her another chance or choose a different song?
Forget it. I'm wasting my time. Melody, you'll never make it. There's nothing there at all. Max, I expect better. We need to talk. Let's do lunch on time.
Okay, so
yeah. I'm off. I've got better things to do.
Now! That was your big chance and you just blew it. Maybe you haven't blew anything for me and Sam. Just forget our deal!
I'm sorry, I don't know what went wrong. Maybe I'm not cut out for this afterward and I should just go back to the family shop.
Don't worry. We all have an off day. Look, while we're here, why don't you play one of your own songs for Erica to hear?
Haven't we got to go?
Not yet. Erica! Wouldn't you like to hear one of Melody's own songs?
Oh, I'd like that. Was Nasty Talk one of Max's songs?
Yeah.
Max always gets his people to cover his songs, so they get the royalties if they have any hits.
And what would you like to sing?
I could do one of my own songs called Paradise.
Okay, let's hear it then.
Just relax and enjoy yourself like you do at college. Good luck now.
might even be able to see about recording a few of your songs.
Can I ask just one question, please? Do you have any problems with your artists being in relationships?
No, not at all. We like our artists to be happy. Why do you ask?
It's just something I've done. I've made a terrible mistake and I don't know if I'll be able to put it right.
Going out sometime. Back to the Future is on at the pictures.
That would be great! Do you mean with the whole gang, or is it a...
each other for a while now.
Of course, Marcus.
I feel like I can tell you anything.
Of course, Marcus.
And we seem to enjoy each other's company.
Absolutely, Marcus.
You sing on a song I wrote and I sound like a strange fart.
Fine. Is that it?
Yeah, cheers, love. I'll let you know when.
Morning, all.
Morning, Mr. Page.
Guys, has anyone seen Jerry?
I wouldn't think he wants to speak to you after what you did to him.
We saw him last night. Wasn't happy.
He wouldn't even go to the pub.
I've been stupid. My dreams got in the way of my common sense. I just need to speak to him.
I haven't seen him. What's been going on?
Max Blake told me he wouldn't take Jerry on as a client unless I split up with him. He wouldn't let me tell him the real reason for splitting up either.
Dickhead.
I might be, but I'll make it up to him when he gets here.
Saying he was going to take you out to dinner. Did you go?
He
no way to talk to someone who's going to make you famous.
Just get out of the way, Max.
Don't forget, my dear, you owe me, big time.
I'm not your dear and I owe you nothing. You done me, remember?
I was a bit hasty in the heat of the moment. After your pathetic audition. But remember, I still have a signed contract.
But you said forget our deal.
It's a bit emotional, it meant nothing.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'm finished with you. You can have your keyboard back as well.
Oh, no can do, my dear. As a used keyboard, so it's pretty worthless now. There's 200 quid you owe me, like it says in the contract.
200 quid? I can't afford that. You'll have to just have it back. I've hardly played it anyway.
No can do, my dear. That's 200 quid. But it can come off the earnings of our new record deal.
That's not fair.
Oh, yeah? Wait until we show this contract to our lovely little Erica, and she'll have to pay me what I've owed.
She won't pay you anything. She'll sort this for me.
We'll see, my dear. We'll see. Much way you're going.
I have a feeling he's going to be trouble.
Don't worry about him. He's not worth it. I'll look after him.
Thank you.
audition and I'll get 60% of your earnings.
60%? Surely 10% is the normal agent's share.
He said it was a standard industry contract.
Oh, it is, but it's my standard terms. Now you work at Heat of the Night Records, and I've come to look at my investment. That's going to make me loads of money.
That's not fair.
All fair in love and money, my dear. Don't forget, make sure you read the small print before you sign.
May I see that contract?
Don't even think about ripping it up. It's only a copy.
When was it signed?
A couple of weeks ago, on the 15th of November. Look, above the signatures, it's all above board and legal.
Mel, I have a question for you.
How old are you?
17. You know that because you made such a fuss about it when I first joined.
And when are you 18?
Next week on the 12th of December, the same day as Frank Sinatra.
Well, in that case, we've got nothing to worry about. You were only 17 when you signed this. Therefore, it is not a legally binding contract. Here you are, Max. One worthless contract. Tip for the future. Always check your performance at 18 before you sign them. I don't care if you're a patron of the college. I never want to see you near my classes or my students ever again.
Who wants a pop contract?
The yes!
Let's hope that's the last we see of Max play.
Oh my God, Mrs. Baker.
Well, the doctor said that without your efforts, I might have been a goner.
So when are you
singer than you are, then.
I didn't come here to be insulted!
You can go anywhere for that.
Anyway, how about you, Mel? Will you be gracing us with your presence now that you're working with the stars?
Yes, the record company said I could fit my course around studio time.
It's a good thing this place is so big, otherwise it'd be in pretty crowded right about now. I hope they bought their own chairs.
Hello, Erica.
Oh, hello, Mel. Happy birthday. Mwah. Mwah. Hello, everyone.
Everyone, this is Erica Knight. She owns Heat of the Night Records. It was Erica who gave me my recording contract, and she's allowing Jemmy to record a few songs too.
There is a contract in here for you to read through now that you're 18. You don't need to sign it until you and your folks are happy with it.
I'll take that point if you like that.
Thanks, Dad.
Well, enough business talk. Let's get this party started.
What a fantastic day. Thank you all for coming.
It's great that you've agreed to become a benefactor of the college.
Oh yes, I'm so excited to be working with Elizabeth and the other students. That is on one condition, that the college severs all ties with Max Blake.
Has anyone heard anything from Max?
Yeah, he came in looking for his phone.
And did you give it to him?
Yeah, but he'll get a shock when he sees the bill. I spent 3 hours talking to family from Australia.
Well, I'll read all this through properly later. But since you're going to make a thing out of this music thing after all, well done, man. Proud of you.
Thanks, Dad.
And if it all fizzles out, you can always come work in the family shop.